Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good day. Ira Epstein of Linen Associates with your weekend edition of your metals market update for this Friday, the 21st of April, 2017. Now, the time right now as I'm doing this about 1:20 in the afternoon, and as you can see, the gold is still up a bit here, and it's going to close in the positive area. I already know the settlement price because it settles at 1:30 Eastern time, 12:30 Central Daylight time, but it trades longer than that. And as you can see, you've had a rally in the stock indices. Now, gold's getting in part supported by the factors that have to deal with the French election. A lot of unknown going there, and it'll react to it one way or the other as we find out who's getting in, well, who the runoff ideally will be between. If it's the far left, far right, that could be a problem. They want to see a centrist, and we think Ms. Le Pen will make it, who is a far right candidate, and then we'll see what that's going to do in the second round of the election. But there's a ways to go. You're getting hurt in areas because energy prices are staying under pressure. And OPEC came out today, and they said that, in fact, the Russian ministry came out. I said that wrong. And they said that they believe that the OPEC and non-OPEC has now complied to 1.7 million barrels a day in cut. The OPEC minister has said that he believes the Saudis will be supporting at the end of May another extension of the cut. Yet Baker Hughes came out today with another rig count that went up. We're about double. I think we were 343 or so last year at this time in rig count. We're more than double that with the count that Baker Hughes put out today. So that's very important. Dollar a little bit, and you would expect to see uncertainty in the euro and a lot of currencies as they just get themselves ready for the French election. Now, what the stock market rallied back off its lows on was news that President Trump said that he has got a plan ready to release next week for his tax reform. As you know, we hit our debt ceiling. That comes next week. There could be an extension of it by a week or so. Don't be surprised, with Republicans, of course, controlling both houses of Congress. But there's horse dealing going on. And you haven't heard from Nancy Pelosi, Mr. Chuck Schumer. You haven't heard any of them. They've been quiet. So there is something brewing. We'll find out what it is, but it's going to impact the markets one way or the other. Either there'll be a lot of more disappointment, or maybe this is the walkthrough that the president gets something this first 100 days that Congress can pass. Everything's been a battle other than executive orders, and even those have gone to court in some cases. So let's take a look, if we could, at gold on a monthly chart. Looking at this chart, you've gone from 1920-70 back in 2011 down to 1046-20 right at the end of 2015, and we are right here. We are knocking on the door of the resistance line at this point in time, supports further down here in the 1140-1150 area. But I think these are the lines that this chart is working with at this point. Now, if you take a look at how the market has been coming up, just on highs to lows, look where you're at, because you did get up so far on the weekly chart, this is the weekly now, to a new high of 1294.80, which is just over $100 an ounce gain since the break low at the beginning of March. Okay, that's not bad action. When we take a look at the market in terms of closes only, look at how nicely it's gone up. You haven't had a big break that's taken out another one, so that's been a pretty one-sided chart. When we take a look at the weekly gold swing line, you got the higher high, but you got a lower low. You have not yet set up a trend at this point in time in terms of higher highs and higher lows. What you do have and did get was a bullish crossover right back here. And it took place not this week of April 7th, but April 13th. And now a week later, we've got the new high. So, in theory, the bullish crossover has carried the market to another new high so far. The Bollinger Band, it has not been able to reach up to, and that's 1302. Now, if Ms. Le Pen were to really win the election in a strong manner, for the second round. I don't think she can get a majority. You probably see gold go up even stronger than that, because people would say, ah, this could be another Trump Brexit situation where the pollsters are not getting things right and she wasn't supposed to win that much. Don't know which way that'll go, but that could be a resistance zone. In terms of momentum, it is still pointing up. So everything on gold is still pointing to the upside. Admittedly, we're getting close to a resistance point. The silver market still has the pattern of higher lows and higher highs. Momentum is faded. The market is now pointing down in momentum. And should the market take out last week's low of 1773.5, I would be making an argument that you might be headed back towards the 1741 level, which does tie in on the daily charts too. Another element there. The high is higher than a previous high. So you can't get a downtrend, but you can get a pattern that says maybe you have to go back to that 18-week moving average of closes. In the copper market, you've had a pattern of a higher high, a lower low, and for the week, the copper is down another 2.5, 2.75 cents. Momentum still pointing down in the market. By the way, if you're asking where are my ETF charts, our vendor, it has nothing to do with me, they have had a problem with the quote feed and they're working on it. So until they get it done, there's not much I can do there. In the platinum chart, the market has got a pattern of higher lows. And if you look at this week's high, 987.50 is the high over that 984.50 higher highs. Notice where the market stuck between the 18-week and the 100-week moving average of closes. What you really need is a close over that in order to start the market moving back to the upside. And you have a divergence. You still have momentum sort of drifting down and prices trying to come up. In the palladium market, you have a pretty clear pattern of lower highs, lower lows over the 18-week moving average of closes, and momentum starting to turn down. So I'd be a bit careful here. This market might want to get back to that 763 level to find some support on. In the dollar index, the market is caught between the upper and lower Bollinger band. Now, that did extend back here. We finally got down to the lower band, and we're making a run for it now. Should the market not get back under 98.67 and back over 101.20, it could get on the bull side. But right now it's in the bear camp. You've got the lower highs. You've had the lower lows. We don't know how far that will extend. And momentum is flat to turning down, drifting sort of, but there's nothing friendly there. So I put that all together, and it's, you know, it's an interesting market, but it's a market that's a bit dangerous right here for a lot of traders. And the reason is, what do you do about the French election, and how do you react to whatever the president's about to release next week as we head into that debt ceiling? This is all really all tied together, and there's reasons that he's able to make maneuvers right now, because somebody wants something from him and the Republicans, and they're going to have to give something up if they want to get that something they want. It's called horse trading. I want to talk to you about Modern Trader, a one-year free subscription, $79 value. Yours totally free. How do you get it? Well, through us, they've allowed us to offer it to you. And it covers stock markets, options, earnings, ETFs, Forex, commodity markets, chart patterns, energy markets, everything you can imagine there, and great stories, technical stories. If you're a technician and you love working with patterns and so on, the current May issue is just chock full of information for you. It comes to you by email. You click it open and it's an automatic reader built in. You'll love it. You can print it out full color, whatever you want to do. Call us, go to our website, sign up for it, or you can click right up here if you're watching it on YouTube, and it will include Market Focus, which comes out to you every day with short new versions of stories. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great weekend, and I'll see you all Monday.